Hello, hello.
Camera.
Why'd you look so happy?
Shut the hell up, boy. Oh. Where's your camera, man?
What do you mean, where's my camera?
Your camera's not on.
It is. Oh, wait, not in Discord, it isn't.
We sound like a Sam people. Victory.
Happy?
Am I happy? I'm always happy, bro. Oh, I need to do the blurriness so people can't see my undercrackers.
It is blurred.
Is it?
Yeah. Look at the side of your headphones.
Oh, yeah. I need to get something to go there anyway. That's something I'm working on. Actually, I want to get rid of this. That's going in the other room next week. It's a wardrobe. I was like...
What are you doing?
I have, like, drawers. Can you see the drawer? Can you guess what?
Oh,
fucking
yeah.
Hell, I'm all on opposites. This is weird.
It'd be great if there was just a fucking dildo hanging out of it, like.
Oh, shit. Turn it off. Put it back.
The fuck? I don't think I'm even recording yet. What the fuck is going on? Oh, no, I am. I'm recording.
John Cena.
What is with you and fucking John Cena this morning?
I saw a clip today. It was just so funny. It was just like loads of things where people falling over and then John Cena. I was like,
where they draw them in, impose them in.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a really good one of like, I can't remember his name, like Baku, is it? Can't remember, the green beast thing from Street Fighter.
Yeah.
And there's one where he just like fucking sweeps people and shit like that. Like kids off of skateboards.
The one where like Peter's shooting, you know, like Peter's got like the shot and he then does the like the geezer from
Who the fuck's Peter?
Peter Griffin. And he does that thing, you know, where he goes, where he's doing the scene from the black and white film with Liam Neeson in, and there's only one bit of colour in the film, it's the girl in the red dress. Schindler's List. And he just like bends down, like takes a smoke. It's like a really good scene.
No one knows what you're talking about.
Everyone knows what I'm talking about.
Mm. Did you get that dragon link I sent you?
No. What dragon link?
Dragon, these nuts across your face.
I was thinking, and I was like, dragon, what can he be dragon?
Dragon, these nuts.
Hey, what can he be dragon? Because he's only got a little nuts. He could dragon over my face.
I don't think you'll have to say that word anymore.
Oh, I can't think you say any word. Nowadays, you might just keep quiet.
I'm going to be better just in case.
I think you just need to stay quiet. No jokes. Like, and what did the sea mollusk say to the...
What did the fox say? Hello. No. Probably can't say that anymore.
No, you can't say that. You just, hello.
I'm a fox.
I'm the fox and I'm Dante the racist badger. What?
the fuck?
Not Dante the racist badger, the crack fox. That's the crack fox's best friend. And he's just like, shoots someone. Because he can't be racist. He's black and white. I've been looking at computer companies.
What? To buy or?
To buy the whole company.
Yeah. By the way, you're being acquired.
And you can build me a PC at the same time. Thank you. Thanks for coming. For custom building that PC that I'm saving up for. It looks like it's going to be around about 2,100. If I buy the parts separately, it will probably come to about £1,712. I've done that on Part Picker.
Don't use PC Part Picker. I always tell people, you not even take... Fuck you, Dave. Honestly, never use PC Part Picker's prices. It never picks from the right places. You always find it cheaper.
Overclockers was a number one. That's quite good. That's also overpriced.
What is this PC? A, what is this PC, right? B, what do you need it to fucking fly spaceships for?
No, I don't do the spaceship flying, man. I do the great FPS on Hell Let Loose.
That is so expensive, man. For a gaming PC.
I'm looking to get a... I've got a mini weird OCD, which probably brings us on to what we're going to be doing to this episode of compulsions. Okay.
Yeah.
So my OCD is, if I'm getting a CPU of 7,800 or 780, right, I've got to get a 7,800 7800 XT as my GPU. And then only the best parts for Dave's mother's son. And yeah.
Oh, man. That's sad. That's sad.
How's that sad? I'm going to have a PC that can act, that like is future proof.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I don't have to build it myself and it up.
Okay. It's okay. Just makes me sad.
What makes you say it, Andy? What makes you sad about this situation?
It's just, I don't know. I bet you could build it yourself for 800 quid less. And I don't even know what parts are in there.
I don't trust. I want to do like the cooler with IO.
Okay.
Have you got an IO cooler?
Yeah. Cost me like 110 quid or something like that.
Okay. I'm on 32 gig.
Right.
RAM.
Right.
Probably not going to ever use its potential.
What megahertz? Doesn't matter how much you got. It matters how fast it is.
6,000.
6,000 megahertz. What is it? DDR5?
Yes. With a white motherboard. The RAM was white. Everything's white. That was the expensive part, trying to keep everything white.
Right, okay. Okay.
I'm not going through for it. I ain't saved enough money up.
Yeah,
I haven't
saved many pennies. You do. That's absolutely
cool. I'm gonna gain advice from you, but the thing is though, Andy, we haven't actually done our episode on hardware. So I have no idea where I am. I have no episode to listen to.
There is no episode. We spoke about this. There is no episode on hardware. All you need to fucking run DayZ these days is a shit PC.
a box with a fan in it.
You don't need much, man. You don't need much at all. I mean,
and a can of Heinz beans in there.
To run it really well, like, you need decent bits, but DayZ doesn't require you to run the game really well.
Now, it's weird, but actually, DayZ runs fine on this PC, and Valheim, when I get on the water, runs like shit. And that's the fucking game.
Yeah.
I ordered the new cable for my headset, by the way.
Oh, yeah. If you go quiet again, I'm going to tell you.
Yeah, I ain't touching that mute button. That mute button's fucked. If I put it on, I don't know if it's coming off.
Okay. So I don't know what is staying in and out of this fucking intro. It might be 2 minutes long. It might be
29 minutes long.
39 minutes long, which is 13 minutes long, which is how long it's been going for at the moment. So do the math. That's how much I cut out. Have we got really much to talk about in the intro? We haven't really, have we?
No. Do a little pluggy.
Oh, yeah. Go on.
Do a little pluggy. Mention a competition.
Okay. That's okay.
We don't know what competition, but we're going to mention it.
Listen, you said this was going to be fucking done on episode 60.
Yeah, what episode are we on now?
57. This is 57.
Oh, good. I thought you were going to say 59. I was like, ooh.
How many weeks in a month? In a year?
51.
Fucking nah, breaking 52, my bro. Balls, bro.
Oh, baby. We have a test calendar which runs from, it actually only says there's 50 weeks in the year because they count out 51 and the 52 like the first week of the year and the last week of the year, so 50 weeks of testing available to us.
And that's your excuse, is it? You've been in that job for what, 3 months?
5.
Has it been 5 months?
Yeah, 1st of August I started, yeah. And I've been shit every single day. Fucking terrible.
August, September, October, November. You haven't even completed this month yet. So you're 3 and a bit months in, you better.
Oh, I'm practically beating this month up, bro. I've done it. Completed it.
Tell you what, you wind me right up. Oh, I wonder what was going on. I've boosted your volume because you were quiet as fuck. Right, I've told you about Dan again now. I wonder why you were so long, loud. No, it's good. It sounds good.
I wonder why I was so long. This guy.
Do the fucking plug before I lose my shit.
Well, you can catch us on these nerds. Spotify, that's our fucking grandest one. Spotify, you hear it there first every single time, without a fucking doubt. Also, you can catch us on Apple Music again. I was gonna say another one. Amazon Music, Audible. Give us a flick on Podbean. Pocket wanks over there. He's doing little pocket wanks. Yeah, pocket wankers. And we are on YouTube. Comes out a couple of days afterwards, and it is a week behind. So, guys, listen to it there afterwards as your second listen, and then go and listen to another three formats, making five in total, because we're upping it from four for a big New Year blast.
Yeah. I'd like to welcome everyone new recently. Had a massive influx of new people listening, new people joining Discord, new people joining Twitter. Got people all over the place. You spread more than...
Amsterdam hooker's legs.
I was going to say Dave's mum's legs. And God. I stopped talking.
Dave's mum's legs.
Because I was thinking of two things. Spread more than Dave's mum's legs, or spread more than Dave's dad's seed. They were the two things that I was thinking of.
One's a compliment, the other isn't. Unless that seed's going somewhere unsavoury.
It's far and wide, bro.
Yeah. What's he thinking about? I don't like that face. Actually, next time we play games and you're getting bored, I want you to put your camera on, because there's a certain face that you pull when I know you're doing a little bit of fuckery. I want to be like, he's going to hit me with a shovel or something. Fuck.
Donk.
Donk. Fuck.
Bro, right. Come on. Well done. The thing is done. What is it called?
Plug.
The plug?
Butt of.
The butt off plug. This week's episode is sponsored by... We're going to have a sponsored section. Sponsored segment, Dave. What are you having?
By the sausage roll guy.
What are you having? No, it's not.
Okay.
This episode is sponsored by people that talk extra loud, even though they're not talking to you, but they talk extra loud to make sure you can hear exactly what they're saying, almost for some sort of invisible approval. And it grinds my fucking gears, Dave.
Oh, mate, kills me off. I'm at the shop. This guy's like, oh, Beverly, I can't wait to go to Northampton this weekend.
Dude, this is almost exactly like my fucking example.
I just give a fuck if you go to Northampton to Terry. Terry, I don't even know if your name's Terry. I can't give a fuck, mate. You're in the front of me in Sainsbury's, bro. I don't hear your life story. Fuck off. Get your nectar points and fuck off.
You've just fucking blown my story out of the water, Dave.
Sorry. That happened to me, actually.
I don't know, I'll allow it. This happened to me today. Went and got I've done some work in the kitchen, basically is unserviceable, can't cook. Went to the chip shop. In the chip shop, there's this woman in there, and she's got a little kid, and she's at the other side of the chip shop. Now, this isn't obviously the biggest chip shop in the fucking world, but this kid's standing right next to her, and I felt like I was inside her mouth. She was like, "What did you do to school today? Do you remember? You had sandwiches, didn't you? Yes, you did. And what did you have? You also had carrots, didn't you? And you learn about... What did you learn about?" "I don't know," says the little kid. This kid's going to be fucking deaf by the time it's five, because all she does is shout, "You learned about stingrays, didn't you?" I don't know why she's asking the kid what it fucking ate. I don't know why she's asking this kid what it had for lunch and what it learned about when she already knows the fucking answer. Like, she's making sure that everybody in the fucking chip shop knows exactly what this kid did for school. And had the
did he make
and
boom
sandwiches.
Boom in the potty?
Oh, mate, it was just... And you know that feeling that you get when someone irritates you just a little bit, and then suddenly everything they do is irritating? You know what I mean?
That's, yeah, life for me.
So it's like the way she opened the door to leave was... God, this is a British thing, isn't it? God, I felt like a really grumpy old man, but she was, mate... I don't understand.
You should have done
it.
Something that was like unsavory, but also a bit like kicking someone that's already heading in that direction when the door shuts. Yeah, that's it. Fuck off.
She's just like farted, just done a massive fart. put her off her chips.
As she shuts the door, like, yeah, get out.
She was at that volume when no one else was talking. There were people in there that were together. There was two other sets of people, a set of people, I guess. There were like four people, two of them were together, right? They even stopped talking because they couldn't hear each other fucking talk, because she was dominating the whole room, having this pointless conversation with her kid about something that she already knew every single answer to.
My dad done it to me the other week. We had a Chinese. I said, Dad said to me, "Do you want to come and collect the Chinese with me?" "Sweet." So we drive from my house to where the Chinese is. 5-minute, 10-minute drive. Not a word spoken on the drive. Get into the Chinese. I'm off to the game this weekend, Dave. I'm like,
are you trying to impress, bro?
I'm like, there's like 3 or 4 other people who are just Chinese. I'm like, yeah, you go every week. You've got a season ticket. He's like, yeah, they got Liverpool this weekend, didn't they? Have they? Sweet. He's like, yeah, they're probably going to get battered, but what the hell? Yeah, yeah, 4-0. And I hope they score a touchdown. Let's go. He's just like,
get a hole in one. Come on, team.
And then he's just like, nah, it's going to be so fun. Cool. You know, you could have brought this up in the 10-minute car journey from the house that you wanted, like,
yeah,
like company for that you didn't speak in. And he's just looking at me and he's just like, why are you a dick to me? Why are you a dick to me? I was like, inside voice. He's that inside voice.
Like, yeah, that's what it's like, mate. It's like they're talking to you at sports day in the field. Do you know what I mean? They're like, come on, Dave, a little bit faster. Go, you got this, mate. Come on. You've been training really hard for this. Like, cool, we're outside in a field, loads of a noise. Not in a fucking Chinese or a chip shop.
Yeah, I know. I said to my dad, when I got back in the car, I'm like, you really don't need to do that, Dad. I know you go to every fucking game. You don't need to, like... Yeah.
I think you're missing the point, though. He's not talking to you when he's doing
no,
that.
No, he's showing off in front of... He's in front... There's other people... There's other fat, balding men there as well. He's like, you know what? I'm not just a fat, balding man. I'm a fat, balding man that's going to Luton at the weekend to watch Liverpool. Hey, I win. Hey, I beat you. And fuck you.
Chatting shit is done. Shall we talk about DayZ shit now?
Yeah. And also, just keep your eyes out on Twitter for our episode 60 competition.
Is that what we're doing? Formally announced.
Formally.
Right. Now, let's be very clear. Is the winner being announced on episode 60? Is that what's happening? Yeah? He's nodding, I think. He nodded once. No? Okay.
No. The episode 61 is where the thing is, but episode 60 is what's where it's going to run through. That's going to be the main bulk.
Right.
There's going to be that week, two-week period of from 59 to 60.
Where's 59 come into it?
Well, we tell everyone what the actual competition is on 58 and 59. Unless this is 58, it's 57. So then, we actually define what the competition is. So then we get people playing through 59, 60, and then 61 is the one that's announced.
Why?
All right. We could do it announced on 60 then.
Well, yeah, that's what I was... You either announce what the competition is on episode 60 or you announce the winner on episode 60. Otherwise, you're just doing it on episode 61.
Well, how about we announce the competition on 59? I haven't actually defined what week that's going to be, whether it's going to be... Is it going to be this year? It's going to be this year in the middle of December.
So 60 is the 15th of December.
That is probably going to be our...
Last episode of the year?
Yeah. Oh, that would work out perfect.
Oh, we'll I announce think it will. I think 60. The 22nd will be our last episode of the year.
Okay. We'll announce on 60 anyway.
Okay.
Regardless.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that makes much more sense to involve 60 somewhere, not skip over it and do it 61. I was so confused.
Yeah, we'll do it that way, Andy.
All right. Okay.
Competition is going to be announced on episode 59, will be the full episode. The full announcement of what the competition's going to be, what goodie is available. And then 60 is where we're going to announce the winner of the grand goods. We just are not going to tell you until episode 59 what that competition is.
Deal.
It'll be good though, trust me. Andy's got great ideas.
No pressure.
Defcon's got great ideas.
That's like a roll intro, dude.
Da, 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 da. Wrong one.
Fucking hell.
Oh no. Watch out. So,
Senor.
Compulsions, Andy. Today's episode is about compulsions and what compulsions we have playing DayZ.
Yeah, so we're talking about things that you just have to do. There might not be a rhyme or reason to it, but you've just got to do it, right?
True. the main one at the moment, because we're in November, for us British people, is if you find some fireworks.
Yeah,
what have you got
enough
to do?
Yeah, yeah, you pick them up and you have to find some matches, or
if
you've got matches or a lighter already,
yeah, you light that shit straight away. Yeah. You don't even care if there's any danger around or it drags anyone. You just light it.
You've got they just got to be done because you're there to have the fun, not the next bastard that finds them. They're your fucking fireworks.
Yeah, that is one of the biggest compulsions I'm finding on DayZ.
Is it? Have you seen the new set of fireworks yet?
No.
No.
Is it like the one from the start of Fellowship of the Ring? The big fucking dragon.
The dragon.
He's coming for me.
Dragon?
It's a dragon.
Dragon, these nuts are across your face.
Oh, fucking hell. Oh, I think I'm dragging fucking Andy down. He's in the gutter with me at the moment. I don't think there's a way out of that gutter, mate. Once you're in there, you're in there.
No, that's it. That's
a slippery slope down, man. Like your mum's belly button. Oh, I think it whatever wanted it to come out didn't come out. Right.
Absolute chaos.
Absolute chaos, like when you set off them fireworks.
New fireworks. This is, I don't know whether this is a spoiler. It can't be a hidden thing because it's already in the game. They just don't spawn yet. So if you haven't heard about it yet, you heard it here first. 10-year anniversary fireworks. So people know about
mate.
The 10-year anniversary t-shirt.
T-shirts
and the chest. So the chest spawns the t-shirts.
The chest
spawns the chest receptacles.
Yeah.
And the fireworks, there's a new type of fireworks where it like fires up in the air and it says like, thank you for 10 years of DayZ, you're awesome, or something like that.
How the fuck did I do that?
It looks pretty good, dude. It looks great.
Must be a drone. Must be drones that go up and do it, like on the London fireworks show, New Year's.
Yeah. Yeah, did you see the skeleton one?
Yeah.
That was really good. Like a giant skeleton made of drones. That's fucking gnarly. Yeah. But yeah, so find those fireworks. They're going to be going off left, right and centre when they're, I guess when they're in like the general release. I don't think they're in vanilla yet, but try it. Yeah. Try it. If you find some fireworks, light them. See if they go off normal. See if they go off for 10-year anniversary ones.
Just check your fives and twenties, guys. You don't want to just set it off for the kid. Oh, look at this guy.
No, don't. It's even fun. It's more fun when you don't check.
Risky. No, look at this. Look at him. Someone's got him in your Winchester aiming at you. Look at this guy. He's just doing it. He's just doing it. If it's out in the open, just don't fucking go near him. I will. I'm stupid. You guys have now got the knowledge not to.
Do what I say, not as I do.
Yeah. What other compulsions do you have?
I've spoken about it a little bit before. I've got a compulsion to pick up every battery that I see.
This is true.
Even if I don't, honestly, if I don't have invent space, I'll drop like a sewing kit to have a battery. Because batteries are so, they're not rare, right? When you don't have them, you need them. For that radio, for the torch, for, I don't know, your fucking NVGs if you're that damn good at the game. But, and then they run out. Obviously, they're a consumable. So if I see them, I got to grab them.
I think what you should be able to do with batteries is combine them with rags.
Or to start a fire?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that wouldn't work in real life.
Or you just combine it with, you could have to have rag as the kindling of
one
stick
metal wire
fire.
To create,
yeah, or you combine, the metal wire is not metal wall. Yeah. I think we've got to go to the way of, if you combine it with a one stick and rag as the kindling fire, it will ignite. And you have to drop it on the floor, but you do get hurt a little bit if you ain't got nothing else.
I guess if you
ruins your gloves. Ooh, ah. That went terrible.
Like
that went bad.
If you bust open a battery, would that set?
Bust a nut.
Do you bust a nut every time you busted open a battery? Probably would, you dirty pervert.
You fucking bust a nut. When anyway. I find a fucking pristine battery, I bust a nut.
But I think last time we spoke about it, I think the reason why I think the batteries are so rare is because you're a loot goblin and you've got them all.
Well, actually, I don't normally have a lot of batteries.
What the fuck is wrong with you, bro?
Batteries.
Batteries,
bro. Yeah, but I find, but like you're saying, you don't have any batteries when you find them MVG goggles or a scope that needs a battery. You have fucking 90 batteries, like what you like to do, and then you don't find that scope that needs a battery. You just have it, man. Yeah, and there's no medium. There's no medium in between, man.
That's the way DayZ works, man. Like, you'll have a shotgun, a Winchester, and a baby AK, and all you've got is 7.62 and 9mm. Do you know what I mean? Like, you got all these guns and no bullets for it. Then you've got all these bullets and no guns for them.
You've got a pump-action shotgun with a mini sight on it, and you're thinking, I'll find that battery anytime soon. You won't find a battery. On your fucking life. Every single radio you found, the battery's been stripped out. Every rangefinder or fucking GPS, the battery's been taken out of it.
Who uses a mini sight on a shotgun? I feel like that's...
I'm pro, bro.
I feel like that's like Chad. Yeah, that's a Chad move.
Fucking Chad. You're a fucking Chad, bro.
If you use a scope on a shotgun, man, like, fuck off. Go away. Go home. Yeah, I'm talking to you.
Fuck off.
Yeah.
Fuck off, bruv.
Fuck off,
bruv.
Have you seen that meme where they turn like the guitar amp to British and, no. and he strums the guitar and he goes, oi, fuck off, you can.
What, like Charles Bronson? Shut up, shut the fuck up.
Okay, me for a fucking shootout.
Have you seen the one where they do the Frozen meme and that? That's so funny. It's like, do you want to build a snowman? And it knocks on the door. Shut up. Shut the fuck up! I need to stay off the internet.
I've got a compulsion that you do, right?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Is it food?
It might hurt your feelings.
Is it food?
It's not going to hurt your feelings. No, it's not food.
Okay.
No, every time we see a deer stand, you know exactly, do you? You have to try and beat me to it. Like, every time. I might be 20... He's laughing a lot. Your mic's not picking you up.
What the fuck?
Because if I might be 20 metres in front of you, you're like, man, fuck this, I'm getting to that first. I'll be full sprint. You're like, I don't fucking care.
There could be a squad shooting at us. Fucking...
I need that compass, bro.
Ruined compass.
Yeah, that's like, that's a compulsion that you definitely have. I don't know where it's come from. I don't know what. But you know it's true, don't you?
My germs of the deer stand. What other compulsions do I think we have as a pair? I mean, we have a compulsion of. When we go near a certain military base, we have a compulsion to go there, and we know we shouldn't. Isn't that right?
VMC?
Yeah. We vow not to go there. I shall not go there. Ever. Not never.
Honestly,
ever.
I'm pretty good with not going there. I only ever go there when you convince me to.
and just like on the podcast,
I'm the voice of fucking reason. I'm like, no, because do you remember what happened last time, Dave? We got fucked up. Do you remember what happened the time before that, Dave? We got fucked up.
And I'm fucking convinced him, like, yeah, but last time I was in fucking Electro, I died. Not telling him I committed suicide. But last time I was there, I fucking died. Let's just go. What could be? We ain't got fuck all, man. We ain't got fuck all. And we literally got an SSG and a fucking P1 pistol. Yeah, come on, man. Let's go.
Exactly. That's why we die, because we've got nothing to fucking protect ourselves.
Oh, but the thing is, though, the last time we really went there, we were on official, and then literally someone shot me with a sporter when I was in the closed headquarters.
That's not true. That was not the last time we went there.
When was the last time we went there?
Usually when we go there, you're like, oh well, what are the chances of us dying there 5 times in a row? Like, do you know what I mean? Actually, do you know what? I think the last time that we went there was where that guy wiped us. That solo wiped us.
Solo wiped all three of us, me, you and Mark.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But that was ages ago, to be fair. That was a long time ago.
It was.
But I think it's going to be even more dangerous now with everybody trying to get to Northwest Airfield.
I was actually headed there on the recently wiped Zero Winter Chernarus.
What, VMC or actually, Northwest?
No, I was in Starry. There was no one around. And I thought I heard a zombie aggro. You know when you think you hear someone aggro? Aggroed. So, I swear I heard it aggro. And then you can't see any movement. You know, fucking hell. I'm stood there, and then all I heard was someone taking in their breath, and I was just like, nope. And as I've turned around, I've literally seen him at the window. So I was at the double green, you know, the end of town,
yeah.
And he was at the, like, stair, you know, the stair house behind the red bricky stair house. Yeah.
Stilted.
And I saw him. No, not stilted. It was like, you know, the one that has a stair that goes to nowhere and then has like a room where it normally has a radio in it.
Oh, yeah. Red brick.
Yeah, I don't know what we call that.
Red house. Brick.
I don't think we... Red brick. Red wine. So we literally, I love Bob Marley. It's great.
What the fuck's that? Tell me your fucking story.
Yeah, and then I then disappeared. I fucked off over to the supermarket area because it's the only way. I knew he couldn't see where I was going because there's fences in the way, so he couldn't see. But he had me in his sights and he had a Mosin and I fuck shit gone out of there, heart pounding, hiding in the supermarket. I'm like, you know, the big supermarket. Mm. So I had like a good view of what was going on. No one ever really goes there. There's no loot there. No one ever has to go there. So I'm like, yes, perfect fucking place to hide. And then I hear him run past, and as he run past, someone shoots at him. I'm like, fuck. Ooh. I don't know if they've seen me. They had a little battle on the hill near the electrical box that's literally just north of there.
Oh shit, yeah.
As I sort of scoped in, I've got a shitty as I've sort of zoomed in with no scope, as I've zoomed in, I've seen a dead body near the electrical box and no one else around. And I had two rounds in a BK single shot shotgun. So I've fucking opened up the fucking thing. He's halfway through reloading. It's like, he ain't got no rounds. He clicked, like, click.
Oh, shit. Well, he was in the electrical box.
Yeah, he was in the electrical box reloading, like, ammo. So he didn't reload his ammo first.
No.
And I fucking just hit him with one shot, buckshot, dead. He would have been low on health. I think he might have been hit once or twice by this other guy. I had two bodies there. So I was, like, panicking, sweating. I'm thinking, oh, something, this could happen to me. I'm fucking dragging gear into the woods just behind, dragging fucking ruined jackets. I'm like, fuck. I get everything I need and I'm like, has it been 10 minutes? Has it been 10 minutes? Sweet. Not going VMC. Where am I going? I don't know. And then my other half got home and I was just like, yes, relief. I'm logging off. I'm like, oh.
I mean, there's like a great example. If he wasn't in there like being injured or whatever, but some people have a compulsion to go and check their kill straight away.
Yeah, man. Fuck. I can't do that anymore. I used to have the compulsion to do it on like the Xbox in my early days. But now I'm like 5,000 hour DayZ player in my cartel. I don't do that shit.
I mean, yeah, it is crazy the things that you teach yourself after getting fucked over a million times by doing it. You know what I mean? So those kind of things turns into like an anti-compulsion. I guess like you now have the compulsion to wait 5-10 minutes before checking the body, you know?
It's the same as a compulsion of with a shotgun. Like, where if you have a choice out of red rounds, green rounds, my compulsion is to unload, if it's got the pump action, unload all the rounds and just load buckshot and leave the green ones until last.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh. I've got a tip. Carry on.
Okay, you're a man. You normally do.
Carry on. That's reminded me of a tip that I'm going to use for this episode.
Oh, great. Do we have the compulsion to find certain items over other items? Do you know what I mean? Do you have compulsions like that? Like, do you search certain areas? Have the compulsion to search certain areas? Do you always go?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So I've written this down on my list. So in preparation for the thing, I'm thinking, right, in preparation for this episode, I've gone, right, what are my compulsions? What are the things that I know that I do, like, and I don't really know why? Searching a hunting shop. If I see you coming out of a hunting shop and I say, have you looted the hunting shop? And you'll say, yeah, there's nothing in there. I will still have to go and loot it. There won't be anything in there. There might be a fucking flag in there. Maybe a baseball cap. You know what I mean? A broken canteen. I will still go and loot it. Just to be sure, you know? Because if I miss out on that box of 308 that you've missed, or that Winchester... What am I thinking you're going to miss? A fucking Winchester with a scope lying on the floor? Like, how are you going to miss that? Although I'm just still going to check.
Been done before, man.
That's why I go and check, bro.
But also, I have the compulsion, if we're talking about locations, to go to our original daylight Xbox base area if I'm on a certain loot route. I have the compulsion to go past there. I don't need to go past there. I just go past there. There's going to be nothing there. It's just in the woods in the middle of two places, but I'm not going to say where it is.
From there, I tell you what, from Staroy, there's two ways you can go if you're coming in from spawn, right? You either go to Guglovo or you go to the fucking town north of it. The amount of times...
Perkovo or something. Yeah.
Whatever. The amount of times that I always go to Guglovo, I don't even know the name of the town that's north of it. Like, I couldn't tell you at all. Maybe it is that I literally don't know, because of how many times we used to go that loot route through Sornichi, Dolina, Staroy, Guglovo, Novi Starry. Do you know what I mean? We used to that route 100 times.
In fact, I think we even miss out Novi now. Like, we don't even go into Novi. Novi's just death town.
There's nothing in there. It's not worth it, is it? It's
no.
Risk versus reward, mate. It's not worth going in there.
You go to the hunting with the medical and the pub.
Yeah.
But also, you know that single road that's just up from that single sort of barn and house that's just up from Gogova on the road to Novi?
Mm-hmm.
I ain't been there in about 4 years.
Why would you need to?
Well, if you just like playing DayZ and you stay to the MSRs, people run into these single houses. There might be great loot in there. Wouldn't know.
Maybe that's what we're missing out. Maybe that's where all the LARs are.
That's where the DMR's going to hang out. The fuck you do? You carry on with your fucking compulsions. I'll be in here, you guns.
I saw a tweet from TRMZ and Anarchy and Marks.
Oh, Marks.
And they were all talking about hackers on Official. And they all started off saying, oh, I haven't been killed by a hacker on Official for ages, right? And same thread, a couple of days later, they'd all got like high-value weapons, LARs, ASVALs, the DMR, killed within 15 minutes to hackers. So it's like almost they're targeting what weapons people have.
Mm-hmm. Somehow they've got software. Someone's got software for anything above like a Winchester. If you've got Winchester, Mosin, Nuog, ASVAL.
Yeah, I think if you have like the high tier, I think Winchester, Mosin, that's probably pretty normal. But if you're running, Org AX, M4, that kind of DMR or whatever, good luck.
AKM, I remember when I got killed in the VMC by the guy with the Sporter sitting 17,000 miles away in the head when I was in a closed room. I had an AKM with three rounds, three mags.
Yeah, but you should have known that you're using it. You're not dangerous.
Oh boy. Meet me on V plus plus after this, bro. I'll
1v1,
show you how dangerous
rust.
You are. Rush. Domination.
Killing spree. What was that from? Was that
Halo? Is from Counter Strike.
No, it's from Halo.
Counter Strike, was it?
No, yeah, because it ripped it. Was it? I think it might have been on Quake first, though, to be fair, or Unreal Tournament or something like that. But then Halo had its own one. We're like, oh, dude, did it come from there first? Like, Kiltacular!
Kiltacular.
Kilimanjaro!
What the fuck?
Genuine. Pucker Gen, no mess tins. Dave, can you hear this?
Yeah? Lighting up green round your fucking mouth. Honestly, I need to get a mic, an external mic, because I never really pick up on my ambient sounds like that, and some of mine are fucking loud. I would have loved it to come out at inappropriate times.
You want to get an external mic just so I can hear your farts?
Not just you, like when we're playing games
everyone.
With the squad. Yeah, just everyone. If you don't want to hear my skittle chewing, you can hear my farts. That's my compulsion.
This is like you wanted to spend $2,000 on a PC just because it's white and the numbers match up.
Well, see, I'll be taking your advice, see?
I mean, to be fair, though, those are beastie pieces of hardware. But hey,
not even
it is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah, there are, but,
plus
you know,
warranty and stuff, you know, all that.
You're buying it from a custom builders.
From a dealer.
Like, as in... Dealer. You're going to be getting that warranty and the help and stuff.
Yeah, cool.
Sweet. So what other compulsions have you got, old bean?
Have you got any more? Because I feel like I've done 2-3 in a row. No, I haven't. I lied. I didn't. Sorry, I forgot the VMC one. I did the last one, though. Do you want to do the next one? Have you got one?
Yeah, I got loads of compulsions, man. I have to, with any fucking gun, if my mag's full, I will load the round in first and then have a full mag of 30. If it drops into 29, I've got to unload and put that mag round in.
I always forget to do that.
But if I only have a mag of 30, AK 74, mag of 30, nice brown mag, I've loaded in, 29, run into a little barrack, there's five rounds on the floor. Sweet. Unload, run round. I feel like I'm gonna win everything.
Yeah, now I'm gonna win all the fights. Yeah, whilst you're celebrating, dead. You are dead.
Out in front of an L shape. Yeah, victory.
I have to place every bear trap I find. Unless I'm in a rush. If I'm in a fight or whatever, I don't know. Absolutely won't. Or if I'm trying to get somewhere to meet up with you, I won't do it then. But if we're on a run and we've met up together and we're just looting, if I find a bear trap, I'll put it down somewhere.
Mm-hmm. In the hunting place, normally.
Usually in the doorway.
Yeah, in the doorway. Remember when we done that once and we were just, it was on the winter Chernarus and we were just on the hunting stand. No, we were in the pub and we heard it go,
ching.
We're like,
don't actually remember
even heard
that,
it.
No.
And we killed that guy. Remember, he was like limping and we were like, oh, do you need some help, bro? Do you need some help? And then,
Yeah, I think you went fucking mental on him and lit him up.
Yeah, because I have the compulsion of, you know, on a winter and harsh server, I need their bones.
Yeah, you got.
And I need every single one. I need every single one. Even if I haven't got room in my inventory, and it takes up four slots for bones, and sometimes you get three stacks of bones on certain servers, I've got to take every single bone, even if it's odd, even if there's an odd number.
Let's see how your compulsion changes in these two different scenarios.
No.
You have a tiny bean and an SKS, right? Don't worry, you've got a really long SKS.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, really, a really long one. Really long.
Massive one.
And, right, you've got an SKS.
Mm-hmm.
Medium gear, you're medium geared, right?
Oh, SKS, top medium gear.
And you see a freshie, let's say, maybe has a shotgun, drinking from the well. Doesn't see you. How hard is it for you to not kill him whilst he's at the well?
Depending on what server. Now, if I'm on a winter server, I'm killing him for his bones. I don't care where you are. You could be in that loading in screen where you're like that. But, you know, if I'm on, say, more sort of like encouraged to interact server, let's say
you're on zero. Or day one, or something like that. Karma crew.
Latin.
You're shooting him.
I'm splatting him on the floor, man.
Oh. See, I didn't think you would say that.
Nah, I do have a compulsion to talk to people and plug the podcast. Just go like, hey, boy. My compulsion is to say, love you, bye.
Yeah.
It's not even my fucking saying. Mine's fucking chow for now. And he's all like, and I'm like, I love you, bye. And I'm fucked up there, boy. What the fuck am I doing?
Well, so I was going to end. I thought you were going to say, Nah, I'm not going to kill him. I'm going to try and talk to him. Fine, cool. Like, not really. Don't have a compulsion to kill the guy because, you know, he's fresh and I'm medium geared. What am I going to get from him? That's the way I'm looking at that situation.
To be fair, we both play quite friendly, as in we do play quite friendly.
Yeah, so I think really, you just lied to me.
My compulsion is normally lying straight away. Say what they want to hear, my compulsion is.
So, as an... on the other side of it then, you're in the same situation, but the guy at the well has NVGs, tac helmet, big old backpack. What's your compulsion to kill him at the well then?
You know, you say that, and actually, my compulsion sometimes to geared guys is to talk to them. Because sometimes, yes, you normally get killed like a good 8 times out of 10. But them 2 times that someone doesn't kill you, you become their pet. you become someone there. They think, like, here's the scraps, and then when they get to know you more, they give you a little bit more. Here's more scraps. Here's larger scraps. Here's my DMR.
I was gonna say, here's my dick.
Here's my DMR. Get on your knees, boy. Yeah. Oh, okay. Like, my compulsion is maybe there's a good bone in that guy's body and he's just going to relinquish his best weapon to me.
There's a good bone in that guy's body, or there will be.
Or bones on the floor when I finish with him. Fucking cutting him up.
Right. Let's have a look. I have finished my list already.
I'm just gonna say, like, like compulsions is like my top compulsions to do stupid stuff. I watch too much YouTube. I watch way too much memes. Phone has ruined my life. And relationships. Not joking.
Relationships, plural.
Yeah, I know. I have one with my phone and the whole world through Facebook. But no, it literally, like, stupid stuff. Like when I get the eye patch on, I gotta go because they are. Like, why are pirates pirates? Because they are. Like, it's, and then drop it.
Oh, that's actually a thing. Whenever I pick up a high viz, I have to go health and safety officer. That's it. Just have
my
to say that.
My compulsion now, when I get a cowboy hat, is to say Yasmin, and then Andy takes it from me and shoots it.
Yeah, or it's like press F4. That's middle finger for console players. Fuck you. Take a screenshot. Send it to Yasmin.
Well, our compulsions are just to give Yasmin shit. Like,
wait, hang on a minute. Say her name again.
Yasmin.
You're saying Yasmin with a. I was saying
Jazz.
Jasmine.
Jazz.
Jazzy.
Yeah, jazz like jazz hands. Yeah.
Oh.
No, it's Jasmine. Yasmin.
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 Jazzy Yazzy.
Hey. She likes bunnies. She likes cowboy hats. She's got her own server now, as we've found out.
Jazzy and Wonder Lazzy. It's not that. It's not that.
It's not that at all.
It's not that.
But yeah, that's my compulsion when it comes to certain clothings as compulsions. Also, got to find the biggest backpack.
Right. We're going to have a quick fire round. It's not a quiz. Don't worry. It's going to round out this episode.
Okay.
Whatever your compulsion is, what one do you prefer? What one are you picking up over the other one? Pretty
much.
First
person.
Right. Now, be as quick as you can. You ready?
Okay.
Double barrel or pump?
Double.
Attack or assault helm?
Attack. Tactical.
Mountain backpack or Toulon?
Mountain.
I knew you were going to say that. So mountain backpack or Alice bag?
Alice.
Fishing or hunting?
Fishing.
M4 or AK?
AK. Oh, what?
It's too late. Hitchhike an oncoming car or hiding?
Hiding.
Press vest or medieval armor?
Press vest.
Pouches or no pouches?
Pouches.
Done.
Even if I haven't actually got a plate, I take the pouches.
Yeah. There you go. There's another one. No, so do I. Pick up. Oh, I might find a press. I might find
a
plate.
I'm going to get a fucking press vest. Never going to go near fucking another military vehicle, like, camp for ages. I got to get this. Cooking pot or no cooking pot?
Cooking pot.
Yeah, do you go for cooking pots? I haven't had a cooking pot in ages.
Cooking pot or frying pan?
Cooking pot.
Cooking pot every day. Every day.
Every day.
Tell us your compulsions. What do you... Everyone's got their own thing.
Andy, I just went for a whole episode of telling you my compulsions.
Listen, bitch. Talking to literally everyone else apart from you right now.
I don't know.
Even people that will never listen to this episode. That's how little you mean to me during this sentence. That was so cruel. Where was I? Tell us your compulsions. What have you got a compulsive trait with? Do you always have to pick some shit up? Do you always have to check out a fucking hunting shop? Like, what's the crack? Let us know.
Yeah, there are some ultimate compulsions out there. And you just tell us yours, man.
There's got to be some weird ones.
Really? So, video of the week today actually is a video of the week.
Thank you. It's what the people want.
Yeah, video of the week is what the people want. And today, video of the week is won by a very good friend, Glaz.
Ooh.
Glaz done a DayZ, the fastest wipe day speed run. It is now based on this new server that's owned by Erno and JLK. It's called Loaded. It's a base building PvP server. Glaz plays on it with his crew of JLK and that. I went on it at the weekend. I found it good. No, you got unlimited stam until you up to a certain weight, and then you get stam and standard, like, sort of high sort of
but end zone.
Yeah, but it's not quite end zone. There is a map, but, you know, it's not as end zone-y. Erno's got his spin on it. Erno's added his sort of stalker stuff. He still wants a little bit of interactions going on. So it's actually a really good combination of ultra modded and sort of vanilla. Ultimate tier mod.
Is it like traders?
No.
Helis?
Expansion mod is on it.
So probably.
I don't know. Probably. But thing is, it's a base building server. Mm-hmm. It's going to be good. It's going to be top PvP. You've got people playing it like Glaz, like JLK, like our good Dutch friend Erno. It's going to be good. There's going to be some great groups in there. There's going to be people that don't even stream, that ultimate players at DayZ. It's going to be mental. It's 100 pop. Always going to be stacked. You're going to have to need to get into that queue nice and early. But what you are going to have is some great PvP on there. Going to have some great content coming from that server.
Nice. Nice clan on clan wars.
Literally, yeah, clan on clan wars. It's literally going to be like, you're going to see some great content coming from on YouTube from Glaz, JLK, all the sort of top tier people that do these DayZ epic movies. But this video here is called The Day After the Wipe. This is the fast speed run where they all want to try and get their base building stuff and get their fucking, like, get their footings into somewhere nice and early so no other one beats there. It's a big ask. It's about 15 minutes long. It's not a movie, epic movie, but it's a little nice, you know, like starter, like an appetizer.
So episode one.
Ooh. God,
you know there's going to be one. You know that there's going to be a movie on this server from
you
Glaz.
You know there's going to be a few as well. There's going to be one from Glaz. There's going to be one from Tommy. There's going to be one from fucking JLK. And Erno might be dabbling in it as well. So check that server out. I have messaged Glaz Andy and said, look, let us know where your base is. I mean, Andy, don't fuck you up. You know how fucking great we are.
Yeah, because we Glaz would, says, wouldn't we? We'd just go there and ruin them. And,
I did actually say to him, just, you know, let us know where you are so we don't get any footings or anything there in case we decide to, like, play it fully, like, stay out of our fucking way. But
he can't say that. Dave, how many times do I have to tell you off for saying that fucking word?
I don't know, man. This is ingrained into me. Right.
Jesus Christ.
I was like, just stay out of our fucking way.
Look, you don't need to get hurt here, guys.
Yeah. Right. You don't want to get hurt.
You don't want to see these guns, baby.
Don't come to a knife fight with a gun. No, wrong way around. Don't come to a gunfight with a knife. With your fucking 5,000 hours on fucking DayZ bullshit. We're going to take you out. I did message him asking where his base was. He says, he says, you'll find it. If you kill me, fair game. I was like, no, I was looking for maybe a little intro, little interaction with you if you're not recording any like content. And he's like, oh yeah, sweet. Give me a message next time you're on. And if you're on the layouted server. I said, we will do.
Nice.
But I volunteered you for something.
Thanks. To get fucking fucked.
I'm there with a Mosin going, oh, I'm pretty fucking good. Then all it is a fucking 50 cow opening up.
Yeah. Oh, dear.
That was a Barrett. Now, I don't know if it's got them sort of like stupid guns on there. I don't think it's got stupid guns on there. But what it will have was, it's not as end zone-y as end zone.
We'll give it a go.
Yeah, we've got to give it a go.
Friendly?
But now, Andy.
Yes.
You're going to try and give the listeners your tip.
Oh, yeah, baby. Zip. Oh. That was my zip.
Rats.
Rats.
Rats. Tiny little mushroom.
A toad from Mario. Little fucking
Chody.
Toad.
Chody toady.
Fuck's sake. Yeah, my tip is stinky. No, is... My tip is about... Now, we've spoken about before hotbarring your ammo, right?
Yeah.
To choose like the different type, the ammo types that you're going to have, right? Here's something that I only found out last week by watching Ceramore. I was watching Ceramore on stream.
Oh, Geez is a legend, man.
And he explained that if you've got two different types of ammo, right, drop one and then pick it back up, that ammo then will be prioritized when you start loading.
So the last one you pick up is prioritized?
Apparently so, yeah.
Wow, I do need to check that one out.
Yeah, because I always thought it was whatever
it is. The top one is top in your inventory.
Yeah, but it's not. But it's good. But that, I always thought that that's how it was meant to be, but it never worked, or only sometimes worked. But I think that the reason why that only never worked was because it's actually the last acquired ammo is the one that gets loaded. Recent is decent.
Yeah, recent is decent. So if you've got red and green shells of a shotgun and you want to load the red shells, drop the red shells, pick them up again. They're the last ones that will be picked up in your inventory. Then your fucking BK113 will load them in, or your double barrel.
Yeah. Isn't that mad?
I think I understood that fully. That's mad. And on that note, and on that bombshell.
On that bombshell, let's outro, baby. Oi! Dun, dun, dun. Another one bites the dust.
Bites the dust. Oh!
Oh, yeah, do a little jig. Do a little
this
jig.
Is why I need an outside mic. I was actually clapping there and you can't hear it.
I don't know why. I don't know whether you've got like a voice activation thing on. Fucking, we'll deal with it another time. Thank you very much for listening to another episode of Friendly DayZ Podcast, episode 57. Insert title here. We've not actually got
just there, just that bit there. Insert the title of compulsions episode. No, it won't come in. It won't come in.
No,
man.
No. We try and coax things out by going to say it and see what comes out, but yeah, it doesn't.
Sometimes it's hard
I just
to
can't
get
help
things.
It.
Oh,
episode 57. I just can't help it.
Yeah. That's nice.
That
has a little bit of a ding-a-ling to it.
Just a little ding-a-ling. My ding-a-ling.
Your ding-a-ling in my mouth. Oh, shit.
Okay.
Hard
candy, did you say?
Yeah.
I'll give you some fucking hard candy.
I've come for hard candy.
I've come to suck some hard candy and just suck some dicks.
Oh, shit. To blow some motherfucking dicks off.
Right.
What did you come for?
We are slowly descending into... chaos. This whole fucking episode has just been us chatting shit. Yeah.
But anyway, you wait until the next couple of episodes when we actually define what the competitions are going to be.
Couple of what?
The competitions... Competitions.
Come.
When there's competitions? That's
come,
not
come,
a weird
my lady.
Competition. You're my pretty girl.
Sugar, baby.
Yeah, but wait for the competition. We will announce it and what it's going to be, define it, so you can all enter, and we will tell you what the prize is going to be. Remember last time, it was a nice G-Tech headset that Cal Days won. He was there wearing it, playing it on his... He's now got a mic, so he had a life. Fair play to him. And he does interact a lot of times with his new headset. But this time... the prize will be as similarly or better.
Oh, now that is a tease. Ooh. Especially that we don't even know what it is yet, but now we have to make sure it is.
No, we know what it is.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I gotta just forget. I don't know. Anyway.
Okay, I just thought, how have I got better memory than you? Yeah. That's just weird, man. Who are you again?
It's all the fucking...
sausages that you eat.
Yeah, all the sausages that I swallow. Thank you very much. Have a lovely weekend if it's Friday for you. Otherwise, enjoy work, suckers!
Yeah, fryer on your drive.
See you later, guys.
Ciao for now. Yeah, probably do a round of a bit. I'll get you a drink off.